limited. We all know that metformin is known, it might be most probably, it's beneficial in terms of cardiovascular complications. Otherwise, all our knowledge is very limited because, for example, data about the effect of sulfonylurea is controversial. I mean, there's a discrepancy between the coming data. Thiazolidine diones, we have an interesting story regarding them, regarding some of them are might be improving, some of them might be harmful. And the other, the modern drugs, incretins and SGL2 inhibitors are still studied. So our knowledge is quite limited, and one of the causes of this limitation is the short-term study. The short time of most of the studies done to study this effect, because well, the cardiovascular complications of diabetes are related to atherosclerosis, and atherosclerosis by nature is a slowly progressive state. So we need time actually just to see if any beneficial effect of anti-diabetic therapy will appear. These are the metabolic abnormalities which happen in diabetes and lead to cardiovascular complications, insulin resistance, high triglycerides, low HDL, slightly elevated LDL. LDL does not be much affected in diabetes, but the size of the particles is getting smaller and more atherogenic, and of course, obesity. We can conveniently divide anti-diabetic drugs into older drugs, metformin, sulfonylureas, and and TZDs, and new drugs which are incretins and SGL2 receptors. Metformin, the first trial which proved that metformin might have beneficial effect appeared in the year 1980, when an patient with ischemic cardiomyopathy, metformin reduced reinfarction, angina, acute coronary events other than acute infarction and death. But the landmark study which focused light on the beneficial cardiovascular effects of metformin was the United Kingdom prospective study, with the results appeared late 90s. It was the first time to prove unequivocally that the metformin, particularly, not any other drug, reduced all-cause mortality, reduced myocardial infarction. The significance was equivocal and significantly reduced death. And in the follow-up study of the United Kingdom prospective study, which appeared 10 years after the finish of the study, proved unequivocally that metformin had a very nice legacy effect when one-third of myocardial infarction was statistically significantly prevented by the use of metformin, unlike any other form of treatment. That's the known part of the effect of diabetes. And there are a lot of studies subsequently appeared, and there's a number of studies which further proved the beneficial effect of metformin on cardiovascular complications. Regarding sulfonylurea, the United Kingdom prospective study, no adverse effects appeared, but in presence of improvement of glycemia and in presence of control or the reduction of microvascular complications, the absence of improvement of macrovascular complications might indicate a deleterious effect of the sulfonylurea. And the analysis, the statistical analysis of the United Kingdom prospective study was too complicated to be able to unequivocally solve the problem. Another study appeared in the year 2006 said that those treated with sulfonylurea only or in combination with sulfonylurea and metformin was at higher risk of adverse cardiovascular outcomes than those treated with metformin alone, as if sulfonylurea has a deleterious effect on the cardiovascular complications. In contrast, another study said no difference appeared there, so there's a conflicting results regarding the effect of sulfonylurea in that Recently, last year, or the year before last year, it's 2013, a meta-analysis, they did a big meta-analysis including 115 trials. In type 1 diabetes, the use of sulfonylurea was associated with increased mortality and higher risk of stroke. However, the overall incidence of major adverse cardiovascular complications or events appeared unchanged. So as if here the stroke and the death increased by the use of sulfonylurea and cardiovascular complications did not increase. The result of this meta-analysis need to be interpreted with caution, the comment of the experts regarding that, because the limitation in trial quality, the quality of the trial, because many of these trial studies included in the meta-analysis was not following the cardiovascular complications in a proper way. So the cardiovascular safety of sulfonylurea, that's the net conclusion, that's the last conclusion, that the cardiovascular safety of sulfonylurea cannot be considered established unless it is evaluated in long-term cardiovascular outcomes trials. That's the way which we need just to evaluate properly the cardiovascular benefits or deleterious effect on cardiovascular complications. TZDs. TZDs have rosiglitazone and pioglitazone. Rosiglitazone has an interesting story, حضراتكم كلكم تعرفوها. 2007 نيسن عمل ميتا اناليسيز اتنشرت يوم 12 مايو 2007 قال فيها انه collectively rosiglitazone had led to increased myocardial infarction in patients receiving rosiglitazone. The record study appeared in the year 2010 and said it's a big study. And said no, nothing happened with rosiglitazone. It's equivocal, no benefit and no deleterious effect. But that study was endorsed, was sponsored by the company which produced rosiglitazone. And because of that, the FDA did not consider the result of this study and put rosiglitazone under risk evaluation and mitigation strategy. دي معناها practically, they stopped it. They just abandoned it from the markets. But in the year 2013, there had been a re-adjudication, إعادة تقييم للresults بتاعت الريكورد ستادي اللي اتعملت سنة 2010 وجابوا independent institute خد الريزلتس كلها رجعها من الأول للآخر اتصل بالpatients وشافهم وقال أبدا ده الروسيجليتازون ملهوش علاقة والإف دي إي اعتذرت في آخر سنة 13 وقالت إنها كل ما تعلموا إنه الروسيجليتازون ملهوش deleterious effect لكن الدواء كان قتل في الفترة دي نتيجة للأذر سايد إفكتس نمرة واحد ونتيجة لأنه خلاص سمعته تم تدميرها عبر وسائل الإعلام والناس ما عادتش فالشركة lost interest في الدراج ولم يعد مرة أخرى إلى الماركت كنا متوقعين أنه هيرجع لكن هو ما رجعش مرة تانية في other side effects الحقيقة ده البيوغليتازون the other member of the TZDs which is pioglitazone which is still in the market we use it so far up till now it increases bladder cancer it's a slight increase but consistent it is present in almost every study of pioglitazone there is bone fracture this is a class effect for both pioglitazone and rosiglitazone and the most serious effect is the fluid retention and increased rate of serious heart failure usually these drugs is accompanied by serious cardiac failure and any physician using this drug has to have to be aware has to be aware by of that serious side effect That's pioglitazone. Myocardial infarction with death might be slightly improved insignificantly. شوفوا حضراتكم الخط جاي على الناحية الشمال اللي هو pioglitazone better. لكن لو تشوفوا serious heart failure محدود في آخر الدنيا هناك على اليمين لأنه ده بيحصل مع التيزيديز بشكل متكرر. ده ملخص الأورال وأنا skip that slide. DB4 inhibitors are relatively young products. إحنا عندنا الإكزامين ترايل اللي اتعملت على الألو جليبتين. قالت إنه إيكوفوكال ما حسنش زي ما كنا متوقعين لكن في الوقت نفسه ما 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 زودش. لكن بالنسبة للهارت فيلر there had been a trend نمرة 2 من فوق الهارت فيلر there been a trend but not statistically significant increase in the rates of heart failure. لكن لما جت متأسف في ترايل السيفر رايت دي سيفر سكيبت السيفر ترايل اللي اتعملت على الساكساجليبتين بينت ايضا انه هو اكويفوكال لكن حصل انكريس في الهوسبيتاليزيشن ديو تو هارت فيلير. الالوجليبتين ما بينش بين ترند فقط مما يشير الى انه جايز يكون ده كلاس افكت. التيكو ستادي اللي معمول على السيتاجليبتين ظهرت يوم 27 ابريل اللي فات اللي فات ده ايه ده من 10 12 يوم ظهرت اول ريزلتس منه بتقول انه حقق الفيرست اوتكم اللي هو نون انفيريوريتي ات از نوت انفيريور وانه ما حصلش اي انكريز في اي واحد من الاذر افكتس وانه الريزلتس بتاعته هتتذاع كامله في 8 يونيو في الامريكان دايبيتس اسوشيشن كونفرنس. ميكانيزم فارت فيلير فلويد ريتينشن جايز وجايز في النون ميكانيزم احنا مش عارفينه. في عندنا اون جوينج كارديوفاسكولار ترايلز بارتيكولار على النيو دراجز. الاف دي اي دلوقتي حكمت ان كل دراج ينزل السوق لازم يتعمل له كارديوفاسكولار سيفتي دراج ترايل ودي كل الترايلز اللي موجوده والنتائج بتاعتها هتطلع في اخر العقد اللي احنا ماشيين فيه ده في خلال الخمس سنوات اللي جايين وبالتاكيد هيبقى عندنا مزيد من الاجابات لكثير من الاسئله. الديزاين كونسيدريشن اللي موجود دلوقتي ان احنا بن 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 دلوقتي المشاكل اللي عندنا ان الفولو اب نوت لونج انف لان يورينا الكارديوفاسكولار كومبليكيشنز وبندور على الناس اللي هم اوريدي at high risk to develop cardiovascular complications. لكن in the future we have to have larger trials, we have to have longer trials, and we have to have a population of high not at high ischemic risk. لأن الناس دول ليهم special consideration. المفروض الناس تشوف الناس newly diagnosed rather than الناس اللي هم عندهم very high risk risk. ونشوف population مع early atherosclerotic disease rather than الناس اللي هم already عندهم established cardiovascular complications. النيور دراجز في ايه عنهم؟ الجي ال بي 1 بيعمل ويت لوس بيعمل ريدكشن في البلد بريشر جايز ده يبقى له بينيفيشال افكت لكن احنا اتعلمنا ان احنا وي هاف تو بي كونزرفيتيف وي هاف تو ويت انتل وي هاف كلينيكال ترايلز وذ هارد كلينيكال اوت كمز وي دونت هاف ذيم يت. الاس جي ال 2 بيعملوا ويت ريدكشن وبيعملوا ريدكشن اوف ذا بلد بريشر فبوتنشالي قد يكون لهم بينيفيشال افكت بس ذي ار ستيل ستاديز وما عندناش اي داتا بالنسبه لهم. ثانك يو.
ااا